Hi, everyone. My name is Carrie Owens, and I have had the distinct pleasure of working with a group of kids that have restored my faith in our future. In the fall, they were told that there was going to be a change. And change can be hard, but change can also be very, very, very good. And personally, I'm grateful for that change. And starting in the fall, we had an extremely supportive staff member, Tammy Williams, who started these kids on a journey to work towards something and believe in something and see where they could go. And I've heard people say thank you to me, and it's ridiculous because I look around in this whole process and everywhere I turn, I'm thanking somebody because everywhere I turn, we've got the Tammy Williams who are bolstering these kids and teaching them choir and beautiful musicianship. We've got David Hester teaching these instrument, the band members, unbelievable musicianship. And we have Eileen Mikulski, administrator, who is teaching these kids beautiful musicianship by responsibility and supporting Tammy and David. And then we have this unreal community of arts. We have Mike Hunter over here. He's not the world's oldest high school student. He is a real professional in this area. And we thank you, Mike. We thank you for being here. It's been a tremendous pleasure for these kids to work with these professionals. Last night we had Larry Avery. And then I would be remiss to not mention a favorite, a community staple and a favorite, who his talent, his brilliance, his years and years and years of being complete and utter support for kids and for the arts, Mr. David Chown. And so wonderfully ironic, he's not here because he's at a gig. And that is what I love to announce for all these kids, because it's working. That's all good. He's making music at this, or making money at this stuff. That is so cool. So yeah, exactly. So I have a short story to tell. And when these kids worked from the beginning, from the fall, and Tammy was giving them steps of, you know, here's how it goes. And then a week before spring break came, and they called Uncle. And Peggy came home. Peggy is my daughter, and she's in the show. And Peggy came home and said, Mom, they asked me to see if you would help. And I said, okay, well, let's talk. So I talked to the couple of kids that came to my house, and I said, what are your goals? And they said, to have a show. And I said, okay, great. My child wants to audition for the show, so I can't run auditions. And so I'm going to hire my personal friends and professionals in the community, and they're going to have a workshop, and they're the ones who are holding auditions. So what if you don't make it? And they looked at me, and they said, we still want a show. That is what the spirit of this whole thing is about. And I am thrilled. So that's how it started, and that's all I needed. And I said at that moment, I work for you, because you are super cool with that answer. So it wasn't about ego, it was about just making something happen. So I'm pulling some very special people out on the stage. Come on out, guys. This is after the goals were a big thumbs up, I formed a student production team, and we have representation from our band program. We have representation from the vocal program, and we also have representation as student producers. So I have a bigger heart from working with these people. They learned this whole process from the ground up, and I can guarantee you that might have been, Tammy Williams is here, I'm just gonna reveal that. And I think Tammy, I don't know where you are, you said Ropee, but you lied because you're not back there, I don't know where you are. So anyway, that might have been the time when we all met at my house once a week and had a big family dinner, and I have the world's most amazing best husband and the most amazing family, because they got kicked out of their kitchen once a week in order for us to have these big production meetings. And I said, okay, who thought it would be this much work? No one raised their hands. No one. And I think, Tammy, that probably was about the time that maybe you started to hear some, oh, wow, thanks. Thanks for many years of this. So without further ado, I would like to introduce these people. I would like to start with my daughter because she's a senior. She is graduating, she's moving on, and it's really hard to live with a producer and director of a program. Really hard. And this girl, anything I ask, Peggy, record these backups and give them to one of the vocalists. Peggy, I need you to work out these charts for this. Peggy, I need you to do this. I need you to do this. Okay, okay, got it. So Peggy, thank you for being my right-hand man in so many ways, and I'm thrilled for you, and I love you with all my heart. Oh boy, let's not cry. Okay, so then we have, I'll start at the end here. I'll start with these two folks, because I love this story. This story, these two amazing people, okay? This is Delaney Jorgensen, and this is Elliot Smith. And you hear a lot of music going on, right? You hear a lot of music going on. So what we have going on is me approaching them at the beginning of this process and saying, you guys want to write some horn charts? So if for those of you who might not know, music is a foreign language. It's a different language, and it's a bunch of black dots on some paper, and it's hard to write. So I said, you want to write some horn charts? They said, okay. And then I said, do you want to maybe make some up on some other songs if you hear some that might fit? And they said, okay. And so what you are hearing back there was written by them and practiced by them. And thank you, Elliot Smith and Delaney Jorgensen. I think 1 week ago, they were writing the horn charts for the final song of the show. Guys, you want to write the horn charts for ABC? Okay. Once again. And we have Grace Argyle. And we have Abe Stone. And we have the brilliant spawn of David Chow. Are done by our other student producer, Olivia Wilson. She is in the light room. Yay, she's waiting. So you are all a part of something really, really special, but it's been 100% my privilege. I'm so excited about all of this, and I told them last night was the opening night, tonight's the closing night. It makes it really exciting. It's even better tonight than last night, and I didn't think it could be topped. So, thank you, all of you, for what you've given me in this whole process. Thank you. You guys have a really bright future. Okay, now beat it. Now, next up, one I like to introduce, because she amazes me like all of these kids, is the bass player, singer extraordinaire, singing a little I Wish, Stevie Wonder, Miss Adrian Evans. Thank you.
Castro singing Something's Got a Hold on Me.
Thank you. Argyle, who will be going to Michigan State for music education next year.
She will be performing New York State of Mind, originally sung by Billy Joel, and this song will feature Kaysen Chown on the piano and Martin Chown on the tenor saxophone.
I'm in a New York state of mind.
House of Blues Ensemble. And we are about to play a song for you, but real quick, I just want to introduce this amazing band that I've had the pleasure of working with for the last month. So, on alto saxophone, we have Kaylin Wright and Kendall Travis. On tenor sax, we have Asher Lucas Cuddeback and Martin Chow. On barry sax, we have Chase McMaster. On trumpet, we have Ethan McKenna and Alexis Frank. On trombone, we have Elliot Smith. On piano, we have Kaysen Mortensen Chow. On drums, we have Sam Critchfield. On bass, Adrian Evans. And on guitar, Mike Hunter, a professional who has been so instrumental to this process. Instrumental. So now we are going to play Swing Machine for You by Larry Neek. It features Asher Lucas Cuddeback on tenor sax. It features Elliot Smith on trombone, Kaysen on piano, and Sam Critchfield on drums. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Hey, it's a real pleasure to play for you all tonight. Our next song was the first song I played at rendezvous practice, and it really set the vibe. I knew it was going to jam. So next up, we got Christina Batsikouras singing Rolling in the Deep by Adele.
Gives him permission, so yeah.
Woo!
Now, another intro for Grace Argyle and Adrian Byer on Mockingbird.
like to give a big thank you to everyone on the Rendezvous staff and production team. This is I joined choir 4 months ago, so this is my first real production. So I've been really lucky to have my first experience with singing with these folks. So please give it up for everyone again. Opportunity, I get to introduce one of my best friends, Dahlia Vincent, and she will be singing Why Don't You Do Right by Peggy Lee, not to be confused with our Peggy Lee Owens. And we will also have a clarinet solo by Delaney Jorgensen, so please give it up.
Song that she wrote herself. Now, I don't know how he could do that. That's like
oh my gosh, you're amazing. It's because you're a genius. You're a musical genius. So, without further ado, please, with great anticipation, welcome Miss Peggy Lee Owens.
Make me happy. Tonight. Thank you for braving the heat and enjoying this night. A big thank you to all the vocalists who have worked so hard on all of their songs, to all the band members who are literally there for every single act, and David Chown, who wasn't able to be here tonight because he's being professional, and another huge thank you to Carrie Owens, who we could not have done this without. Let's give a big round of applause. So without further ado, our closing number is ABC, originally sung by the Jackson 5, now being sung by the Vocal Heirs.
Oh,
Okay, everyone. Just stay in your seats. We have one final surprise for you guys. I think we're just waiting on
Olivia.
This person right here.
And I need to get my guitar.
Okay. Hi, everyone. I wanted to thank you again for coming out to the show tonight. I know it's said a thousand times, but the one thing I had to say is that I have so much to be grateful for when I think about high school, but the one thing that I would never have gotten through these 4 years without are my peers. These people right here, they mean everything to me. And sorry, to be honest, it's gonna break my heart when we all go our separate ways this coming fall. And but no matter how much distance is between us, you guys will always be my family, away from home. And I'm so profoundly thankful for all of you. But to get on with the show, and the last song for the show is gonna be performed by us. It's kind of an ode to all the seniors that are gonna be making their way into the world. And this is Michigan, originally performed by the Milk Carton Kids.
Took the words right out my mouth. great night, everyone. Drive safely.